Εξομολογήστε το Κύριο ότι αγαθός, ότι στον αιώνα το έλεος αυτού. Εν Ιορδάνη βαπτιζόμενου σου, Κύριε, υπ' της Τριάδος και φανερώθη προσκύνησιν. Του Αργιελίτορος η φωνή προσεμαρτύρηση, αγαπητών σε λίον ονομάζουσα. Και το πνεύμα εν είδη περιστεράς ευεβαίουν του λόγου το ασφαλές, ο επιφάνης Χριστέ ο Θεός και τον κόσμο φώτισα δόξα.
Κύριε ως αγαθός, ο Αγίου Τάτης Αρχιεπισκοπής, δια Κύρων και Μεγάλης Βρετανίας, υπερτίμου και εξάρχοντικής Ευρώπης και Ιρλανδίας, ημών του Ευαρχός και Πιπενάρχου, πολλά τα έτη.
Κυριάκου του Γεωργίου, υπερών ευλαβικά μνημόσυνα επιτελούμεν και πάντων όν τα ονόματα εν τη Αγία και Ιερά Προθέσια μνημονεύσαμεν ζώντον τε και τεχνεό των αδελφών ημών και ονέκαστος κατά διάνοιαν έχει γνηστεί Κύριος ο Θεός εν τη Βασιλεία αυτού πάντοτε νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων νέοι αυαλουρκότ remember all of you εν του απειλάβετη πάτερ in his kingdom now and forever and to the ages of the ages.
Παραγία Πατέρα, Σαχράν, υπερβελουμένη σε δόξο τε σπίτι, Σιμώντα,
Αγία,
Αγία, Αγία, Αγία, Αγία, Αγία, Αγία, Πάσα τη ζωή ημών, Χριστό το Θεό παραπομεθά.
And it seems that this is not far away from the truth, because one living here and noticing the tradition, what which exists, and the people live understands that this God came very early. Very apart, very obvious. And we are very happy to continue and live together with the people here. Today is the Sunday after everybody, and it's still everybody. We celebrate, as you know, the presence, the appearance of the Holy Trinity on the Epiphany Day. And the complete change of the world, the universe, with the presence of the Lord in the River Jordan, what the Father is speaking, that this is my Son who I love, and what the Holy Spirit appearing in the form of a dove. Therefore, this renewed say, of the whole creation is very important for us, and we try to live up to it. Θα μου επιτρέψετε τώρα να πω και λίγα στα ελληνικά. Είμαι ιδιαίτερα χαρούμενος που βρίσκομαι και πάλι εδώ στην Κυρία αυτή, ήμουνα και τον Νοέμβριο που γιορτάζατε τους Αρχαγγέλους και έτσι τα έφερε η Υγεία Πρόνοια να είμαστε και σήμερα μαζί σας. Και αυτό μεταφέρουμε σε όλους τις ευχές και τις ευλογίες του Θεβασμιωτάτου και χαιρόμαστε που η κοινότητα διοργανώνει αυτή την εκδήλωση και τη συνεχίζει με τόση αγάπη, με τόση κοντήρα, με τόση, θα έλεγα, αφοσίωση. Γι' αυτό να ευχηθούμε να είμαστε όλοι καλά, να συνεχίζουμε, να είναι η χώρα όπως είναι ειρηνική, όμορφη, για να ζούμε όλοι ευχηθέντε και χαρούμενοι. We are extremely happy because so far then got to that peace. We didn't have any help, and that's the role that all of us have continued to live. We all celebrated the 19th birthday of our Queen, and we are very happy because during her reign we had a very important task. A girl devotion to the Church is very very important. Everyone is precious. This is very good. Δεν θα σκουράσω άλλο. I'm not going to.
Thank you. Thou art my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. Επεφάνισε ημερών άτομα είπαμε. They allow us just five. Τώρα.
Ευχαριστώ. Thank you.
You're welcome. Ο Αλέξης. Ο Αλέξης γιορτάζει αυτό το μήνα, τον Ελένη Γενάρη. Όλο το μήνα. Άντε, παίρνει. Βάλε καμιά ωραία. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίου Πνεύματι και νυν και αεί και σ' άνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Κύριε Λέσον, Κύριε Λέσον, Κύριε Λέσον, Δεσποτάγιε, ευλόγησον. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Master, keep the blessing.
Χριστέ ο Θεός ημών ευλόγησον την πρόσκυνη υπόσχεση των δηλώσεων σου τέξου πάντα νυν και αεί και σ' άνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Jesus Christ, our Lord, bless our food and our drink, which you receive for our sustenance and in your glory. Καλή όρεξη, bon appétit.
Ladies and gentlemen and distinguished guests, I have the pleasure to introduce the first of the speakers, the worshipful, the Mayor of Margate, Councillor Robin Edwards.
Mr. Deputy Lieutenant, High Commissioner, First Secretary, Madam High Sheriff, my Lord Bishops, Chairman of Council, Kenford Council, Right Worshipful and Worshipful Mayors, Members of Parliament, Reverend Ladies and Gentlemen, Ladies and Gentlemen, Yasu Kalispera. Once again, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to Margate. We were discussing on Wednesday just last the weather outlook for this day. Nobody really knew what was going to happen, and nobody could recall it raining actually on the rest of the sea's day. Fog we've had, snow we've had, but no rain. I tend to believe that. I'm sure we're all glad that our run of luck with the weather has held firm. This is the jewel in Margate's mayoral calendar year, and as mayor, I am sure the Charter Trustees would agree with me. This unique occasion allows us to annually affirm the close ties and friendship we share with Margate Street community. Last year, I expressed hope that the negotiations when then taking place to resolve the situation in Cyprus would finally reach satisfactory conclusion, which it hasn't at the moment. Those talks are still going on, so once again, the best wishes to the people of Margate and the guests assembled here are for a satisfactory and happy outcome that will bring peace and confidence for the future to the inhabitants of the beautiful, friendly Mediterranean island, birthplace of Aphrodite, the goddess of the love. So, Aphrodite. Oh, Aphrodite. Okay, says Aphrodite. And I am in no doubt that certain young men here today would have preferred the warmer waters of Cyprus rather than a chilly North Sea. He's braver than I am, I can put a little finger in. But we are all gathered here in friendship, and as a token of friendship, I would like to offer you, my Lord Bishop, this peace lily. And also peace lily to the High Commission. we may wish for this long-wanted peace. Now my thanks go to the Winter Gardens for a very nice meal. I rather enjoyed the mulled wine when we came in from the cold. This year is a special year thanks to those organisations that have worked so hard behind the scenes to enable this event to be a success, the success it is. And on behalf of the people of Margate, my thanks to you all for coming here today and joining together to celebrate this tradition and the blessing of the seas. Thank you. Just one more little thing. Ingrid, the PA to the mayor, it's her birthday today. I'm not going to say which one, but if she would come forward. It's her actual birthday.
President of Margate Green Community, Mr. Michael Papadopoulos.
Good evening. Right Reverend Athanasius, Bishop of Tropea, Right Reverend Trevor Wilmot, Bishop of Toba, Mr. Frank Martin, Deputy Lieutenant of Kent, Mrs. Catherine Smallwood, High Sheriff of Kent, Your Excellency Eurybiades, Cyprus High Commissioner, First Secretary of the Greek Embassy, Mr. Sotirios Domestikas, Sir Roger Gale MP, Mr. Craig McKinley MP, Chief of the Kent Police Constabulary, Sharon, who have I got left? Mr. Worshipful Mayor of Margate, Mr. Robin Edwards, Your Worshipful Mayors and Mayoresses, Chairman of Council, Charter Trustees, Members of the Clergy, Mr. Minaidis, President of the Greek Churches, and ladies and gentlemen, welcome. We're so glad to have you with us tonight. Last night I was looking at the list that Ingrid very kindly sent me. And I saw that at least 20 towns are represented in this function here tonight. Thank you very much. It's fantastic. As far south as Folkestone, and as far north as Bradley-on-Sea. A round trip of 250 miles. Thank you very much for being here. I'd also like to thank my Greek compatriots that came from London, and that's a long trip as well. So thank you very much, Kiri Abdullah, Dulla Tours, thank you very much for coming down. Now on behalf of the Greek committee, I would like to welcome all of you to the celebration of Epiphany, a festival whose origins are rooted in the midst of time, commemorating not only Jesus' baptism, but also his divinity, which according to Christian belief was manifested when John the Baptist baptized him in the River Jordan. Epiphany is one of the oldest Christian feasts. It was celebrated since the end of the second century, even before the Christmas holiday was established. It is indeed a great honor that so many of you join in with us, observing and rejoicing in this great feast. Ours is not a large community, but we take pride in what we have accomplished in our small town. We try to preserve the customs and traditions of our motherland whilst also joining in with the customs, traditions and way of life of our host nation. This festival is one of the traditions we brought with us, and we believe that it has enriched community life here in Margate. It has helped integration and cooperation. It has enhanced the relationship between the civic authorities in Margate and our community, and we are very proud of our contribution. At the same time, we are indebted to Right Reverend Trevor Wilmot, Bishop of Dover, who has been attending and participating in this festival every year without fail since 2011. The Bishop has been at the forefront of inter-church cooperation, permitting us to use All Saints Church anytime we needed it, especially when we expected a much bigger congregation than our little church could accommodate. We sincerely thank him for his generosity. Thank you, Lovin. This year, we are pleased to announce that due to the generosity of one of our recently deceased compatriots, we have been able to acquire a building which we plan to develop into a community center. It is situated in Westgate, and our intention is for this center to further facilitate the integration and cooperation with the local population in that area. It will be available for everyone to use and enjoy. For as St. Paul said, there's neither Jew nor Greek, there's neither slave nor free. There's no male or female, for you are all in Jesus, you are all one in Christ Jesus. We already held 3 charity events there, and the participation of the local population was overwhelming. The project is a long way from completion, as we do not have the funds needed. But when complete, it will be another link between the Greek and the local communities. Today is very much a religious occasion, but our hearts and our minds cannot but wander back home to Cyprus, a little island which was invaded and torn apart, forcibly split in two, and for 43 years not allowed to heal its wounds. Tomorrow, a new round of talks begins. We hope and pray that at last a just solution can be found, allowing all the people of the island to live in peace and prosperity on the land of their fathers. It will be truly a blessing for all if this can be achieved in 2017, a year when a Cypriot town, Paphos, is chosen as a European capital of culture. It is indeed a great honor for this little but amazing town, half the size of Margate, to be chosen. We should not be surprised, however. Paphos has so many attractions. It is included in the official UNESCO list of cultural and natural treasures of the world's heritage. Once more, I thank you all for being here with us. We truly appreciate your presence and participation. We hope to see you again next year. Thank you all very much indeed.
By silence for the Greek Orthodox Church of Archangel Michael's resident priest, Father Vizeri.
Your Grace, Bishop of Tropea, Your Grace, Bishop of Dover, Lord Mayor of Margate, Mayors and Mayoresses, from all over Kent and beyond Kent. Κύριε Υπαταγνωστά, κύριε Γενική Πρόξενε της Ελλάδος, αγαπητοί συμπατριώτες. First of all, I would like, as a priest and spiritual father of the community, to welcome you once again, and thank you very much because it's a very big thing for us, give us hope to continue what we do 52 years now in this community. Every year we are here and we bless the seas by the grace of God. And it's a very big day, not only for us, for the Greek Orthodox community, but for the local community, for all the town, and for all Thanet. Thank you very much for participating. Please allow me to say a few words in Greek for those who came from London especially. Σας ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ που ήρθατε. Ευχαριστούμε Θεοφιλέστατε που είστε για μία ακόμη φορά εδώ κοντά μας, εκπροσωπώντας τον Σεβασμιότατο Αρχιεπίσκοπό μας. Είναι μεγάλη τιμή που μας κάνετε κάθε χρόνο, αλλά βλέπετε τι έκταση παίρνει αυτό το γεγονός που γίνεται εδώ σε αυτή την περιοχή του Ηνωμένου Βασιλείου κάθε χρόνο. Προβάλλεται από πάρα πολλά μέσα, και από το διαδίκτυο αλλά και από την τηλεόραση, από τις εφημερίδες. Και ενώ αριθμητικά είμαστε μικροί, ταυτόχρονα είμαστε και πάρα πολλοί. Σας ευχαριστούμε πολύ και εσάς που ήρθατε από μακριά, γιατί δίνετε δύναμη και σε εμάς και στον κόσμο μας εδώ. Και να το συνεχίσετε να το κάνετε. Once again, thank you very much and have a happy new year, all of you.
I will now introduce the Right Reverend Trevor Wilmot, Bishop of Dover.
Your Grace, beloved brother, Bishop Athanasios, it's a great delight to have you amongst us again this year, but perhaps you will allow me as the Bishop, the Anglican Bishop here, to convey through you our love and our greetings to His Eminence, Archbishop Gregorios. The very presence of the Orthodox communities amongst us, particularly here in Margate, reminds us, as we've heard from Michael already, there is more that unites us as Christians than could ever divide us. And this gathering together today reminds us of brothers and sisters in Christ across the world who are literally suffering for their faith in Jesus Christ, many of whom belong to Orthodox churches who are bearing the cost of their faith in Jesus Christ. Dear brother, please be assured we remember them in our prayers day by day. But also, we have to be honest, as we celebrate today, we live in a very dark world. The continuing violence in the holy city of Jerusalem this morning reminds us of that violence and that division. And so as we have prayed and been allowed to share in the blessing of the great waters today, as we praise God and bless Him, ask Him to bless His creation, His world, we realize just how fragile that world is, and the commitment by our presence here today, in each in our own small way, to be bringers and providers of peace to the communities of which we are part. We all join, those of us of faith and all of goodwill, in holding before us the discussions which will begin afresh tomorrow. There could be no better sign of a world that seeks to live in peace than the reunification of the great island of Cyprus. It seems to me those two communities, and I pay huge tribute to Sir Roger Gale, amongst many others, who over many years have kept alive for us the challenge of bringing peace to that great island. By God's grace, this will be the year in which that peace will come to all communities, because I know from the Greek Cypriot community particularly, you seek that reunification for all the people of Cyprus. It's a great delight for me as Bishop of the Diocese of Canterbury to be here and to bring you, dear beloved brother, the greetings of His Grace, the Archbishop of Canterbury. We hold your presence among us as a sign of that unity which we bear together. Dear brother, thank you for being with us again this year, and take back to the whole of the Greek Orthodox community in this country our prayers and our love for all of them in Christ Jesus.
The First Secretary, the Embassy of Greece in London, Mr. Sotrios Demistakis.
Θέλω να ευχηθώ χρόνια πολλά σε όλους. Για εμάς που ερχόμαστε από το Λονδίνο, είναι πάντα πολύ όμορφο να βρισκόμαστε εδώ κάθε χρόνο με αυτήν την δυναμική κοινότητα. Πέρσι, τέτοια μέρα, ήμασταν εδώ όταν ξεκινούσαν οι προσπάθειες για αυτήν την διαπραγματευτική διαδικασία που βρίσκεται τώρα σε εξέλιξη. Και σήμερα είμαστε πάλι εδώ όταν ξεκινάει πλέον η τελική φάση της διαπραγμάτευσης στη Γενέβη μεταξύ της Κυπριακής Δημοκρατίας και της Τουρκοκυπριακής Κοινότητας. Οι ελπίδες όλου του ελληνισμού, οι προσδοκίες όλων των Ελλήνων είναι αυτή τη στιγμή με τον Πρόεδρο Αναστασιάδη και τη διαπραγματευτική του ομάδα. Είμαστε βέβαιοι ότι έχει γίνει καλύτερη προσπάθεια για μια υπόθεση η οποία σπάρασε την καρδιά κάθε Έλληνα. Ό,τι και αν γίνει όμως το τέλος, όποια έκβαση και αν έχει αυτή η διαδικασία, θα γνωρίζουμε πάντοτε ότι το δίκαιο βρίσκεται με το μέρος το δικό μας. Όλος ο πλανήτης αναγνωρίζει και αντιλαμβάνεται την Κυπριακή Δημοκρατία ως ανεξάρτητο κράτος και καμία αλλοιοντότητα. Και αυτό είναι μια μεγάλη αναγνώριση για όλους μας. In fact, over the past 30 minutes, I've been filling out my name on the raffle tickets. So I think next year you should ponder some more practical way in selling these tickets, because this one hasn't been very efficient. I'm joking. So, Mr. Gale, Mr. McKinley, your brave nation is involved, as we all know, in the Cyprus question. So, what do we all expect from you and from Her Majesty's government is never to forget who is the aggressor on this case and who has been the victim. Nicosia still is a city where foreign military troops are lying within the city center, literally. And this is not a commonality, it's a reality, in fact. So it all reminds us that we must all exert our pressure in order to see this situation resolved in a just way. So let's wish that this procedure that's now undergoing in Switzerland will have a fruitful outcome. And let us all wish Chronia Pola for the blessing of the waters. And may all we meet next year again here in Margit. Thank you.
I now call upon Cyprus High Commissioner, Mr. Europees, EVVDs, Vitek.
Don't worry, I've been called worse things in my life. good evening, everyone. Chronia Pola. I'm very cognizant of the fact that a short speech moves the hearts and a long speech moves chairs. And several distinguished speakers preceded me. So for the benefit of time, I will cut my remarks and make them very, very short, from 1 hour and 45 minutes to minus 1 hour and 42 minutes. So this is the fourth year that I'm coming to market, the fourth consecutive year that I'm coming to market, and I really feel blessed. And on the way coming here, and I said, why am I jubilant? Why do I feel good coming to market for yet another year? Don't have anything better to do on a Sunday? And frankly, I don't. It's a blessing to be here with you, because when I see how the traditions of our faith come and meet the traditions of the Anglican faith, and how it meets the traditions of this beautiful city, Margate, and how it all becomes a symbiosis and becomes one. And seeing so many distinguished mayors that are here, more than 20 cities, and so many of you that you have taken time out of your precious schedule to be here, I said, this is a blessing. And therefore, I want to pay tribute to you, I want to pay tribute to the community, I want to pay tribute to each and every one of you for taking the time to be here. Your Grace Bishop of Dover, Your Grace Bishop Athanasios, many, many others that are here. And of course, I would be remiss if I were not to say that I'm additionally happy because I come to be at the patch of Sir Roger Gale, who is an all-weather friend of Cyprus. And I say all-weather friend because when the sun is out, when the birds are singing, when it's spring, you know what? You have lots of friends. But when the thunder comes and when the lightning comes, then somehow friends tend to disappear. Not in the case of Sir Roger. So I want to pay tribute to him in front of you. And of course, behind every successful woman, Susie, there is a successful member of parliament. So, Susie, yeah. So Susie is the power behind the throne. And also to pay tribute to Greg McKinley, even though it's the second year that we get to meet, and I want to thank you as well. I think my 3 minutes are up. I want to say health, happiness, prosperity to you and yours. May 2017 be the annus mirabilis, a year of good tidings for Cyprus, which we all hope for, because what we want is nothing more and nothing less other than what is given to other civilized people. Democracy, human rights, and the rule of law. Nothing more, nothing less. But also, of course, much more equally importantly for the entire world, because as His Grace said, 2016 was an annus horribilis, it was a terrible year. We see what happened today, another terrorist attack in Jerusalem. So let's hope that through the grace of God, let's hope that through His teachings, the brotherhood that He teaches us, today are not Sunday school stuff. There is practicality in all this when we're talking about tolerance, understanding. Do unto others as you would have others do unto you is the golden rule of so many religions that I know. So, υγεία, χαρά, μακροημέρευση, στήρων κακού, σας εύχομαι κάθε καλό σε εσάς, την οικογένεια, στα παιδιά σας. Σας ευχαριστώ που κρατάτε ψηλά τη σημαία της Κύπρου και της Ελλάδας, γιατί αν δεν τα κρατήσετε εσείς, κανένας άλλος δεν θα το κάνει. Και γι' αυτό είναι η μεγάλη παρακαταθήκη μας, να ενσωματωθείτε σε αυτό τον κόσμο εδώ, δίχως να αφομοιωθείτε και να κρατάτε ψηλά τα ήδη και τα έτοιμα. This is our DNA. So, blessings to you, each and every one of you. Thank you. God bless.
Sir Roger Carr.
President of the community, Your Excellency, my friend Eurybides, Your Graces, distinguished guests, ladies, gentlemen, Kaisersas. This is the 33rd of, I think, 51 years that I have attended the Blessing of the Seas here in Margate. For half a century, the Cypriot community has been an integral part of the life of this town. And it's a recognition of the importance of these events and of this community that so many of our distinguished civic dignitaries are here to help you celebrate today. You are important to Thanet, you're important to Kent, and your community, the Cypriot community, is important to the whole of the United Kingdom. deeply grateful, as are my parliamentary colleagues, to those of you who have travelled so far today to be with us here in Margate, and I'm particularly grateful to Councillor Jason Chalambos for joining us as well. Please bring more next year. Most importantly of all, can I thank the young man who braved the waters again today. Rumour has it that Elfin Safety tried to interfere. You just keep on swimming, son. I'd like to address just a few remarks, if I may, to the Cypriot community. As you've been told, tomorrow and on Tuesday, the President of the Republic of Cyprus, Nikos Anastasiadis, and the leader of the Turkish Cypriot community, Mustafa Akinci, will be meeting to pick up the talks where they had broken down. And an enormous amount rides on that. Back in October, the leader of the Turkish delegation to the Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe, Talip Kuçukan, told me that President Erdogan wanted a settlement by the new year. Well, that has not happened. And sadly, part of the reason for that, I fear, is the intransigence of President Erdogan. But yesterday, following a visit to Greece and Turkey by Sir Alan Duncan, the Minister of State at our Foreign and Commonwealth Office, the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Theresa May, spoke with President Erdogan. My understanding is that that conversation was promising. Now, you know and we know, but there is a long way to go before a settlement is reached. There are far too many red lines. There are still a number of stumbling blocks. And if and when, and I believe it will be when, a settlement is reached, then it still has to go to a referendum of both communities in the northern part of the island, the occupied part, and of course, in the Republic. But the only way forward is through goodwill. My parliamentary colleague, Craig McKinley, and I, the Parliamentary Friends of Cyprus, the all-party parliamentary group, will all work with you and alongside you to seek to bring about the result that we all wish for. I am a citizen of Morfou. I want to go home to my town with my friends in freedom. And I want it to happen this year. Believe me, we will stay with you for as long as it takes. But ultimately, we will get there, if we stay.
I now introduce Bishop Athanatos. Thank you.
Dear brother, members of parliament, and fair citizens of the area, and all the other mayors and distinguished friends, I will call you. We are very happy to be with you today. Allow me to bring the blessings and the love and the greetings of our Archbishop, who I believe most of you know him in person because he used to come for many years here. Personally, I think it's the third or the fourth time I came for this occasion. I'm very happy to be with you, and I take this opportunity to thank the Church of England in your presence for all the help we received as Orthodox Church in this land. Most of our buildings we use for worship, they were given to us by the Church of England. We are thankful and grateful. Thank you also for the protection and the guidance of our community here. Thank you. What else shall I tell you? This year, his Beatitude, His All Holiness, our Patriarch celebrated 25 years in office. We visited him quite recently and received his blessings. I remember him coming to this land more than 40 years ago. He used to come as a deacon, then as a metropolitan, and as a patriarch came at least 5 or 6 times and received titles of honor from many universities. He knows the land here and he loves it. And we are very pleased for that, because he is connected with all the archbishops going online a number of years. I will conclude thanking you and wishing you every happiness and a very blessed new year. And let's hope that the Queen will continue in good health. Thank you very much. Where is the young man? Do come along. Congratulations, thank you very much. We wish you every success in your life. Thank you.